Hey, it's me, the third episode of MMD School. Before we start, I want you to take a deep breath. MMD is one of the easiest 3D programs to use. I actually find animating with MMD easier than with 2D animation. Anyhow! Step 1, the starting pose. First, pose your model. This will be the first frame of animation. If you don't know how to pose your model, don't fret. I have a tutorial at the top right corner of the screen. Once you have your pose, select all and hit register. Otherwise, your frame will not be counted. Step 2. Optional. Magic button things. Psst! Here's a little MMD secret that is handy in posing and a lifesaver in animation. In bone manipulation, there are these three magic buttons. Copy, paste, and reverse. Basically, you pose an arm or leg bone on the left side of the model's body. Hit copy, paste, and reverse, and the arm or leg pose is copied, pasted, and reversed on the right side. Try it! Doing this does not make you lazy. Sounds wise in your MMD. Step 3. Making a frame. After making your pose and hitting register, go into frame manipulation and go forward a few frames before posing your next movement. After your starting pose, do not select all before hitting register. That will make the animation choppy. Nope, instead, only select the bone that you're moving in that frame. In this animation, Miku is talking. From the bottom left corner, you might see me trying to use the interpolation curve tool. This is the topic of another video. Oh look, it died. You can see me animating a blink or two in this one, which is good, but the trick is to have three consecutive frames. One frame where the eyes are closed halfway, one where they're closed completely, and another where they pop right back open. The real secret to animating is to add lots of body twitches. You make the model's eye twitch, make a finger move, just loads of little unconscious movements randomly. I never saved the animation, so I'll have to start over from the pose. Like this video, and I'll redo it as a motion download. After you have finished your animation, go into Edit and click Select All Bone Frame. There are a lot of options for selecting frames, but for this animation, it only has bone and facial frames, so I'm only going to be using those. Then, go into File, and click Save Motion Data. Then give your file a nice searchable name, and make sure that it is the Vocaloid Motion Data file. I'm going to be updating my test motion file. I just want to say that I want my MMD students to ask and answer questions in the comments. If you have an MMD-related question, start your comment with the hashtag MMDSchool so that I can see it. I want to build a community that is curious and not judgmental. That's it for this week in MMD School. Goodbye, class!